What's up guys, Brian here, and I'm back again with another awesome video. Today I'm going to share with you guys three features in Photoshop that will save you time. Now this is really useful if you work for long hours on Photoshop, or if you work on big projects that require you to edit for a long time, or let's just say you just use Photoshop. Even if it's for smaller projects, it will still be useful. So with that said, let's begin. The first feature I'm going to share with you guys is called Action. Actions are a set of automated processes in Photoshop. So let's say you do a certain thing over and over again and you want to cut yourself the stress of always going through it over and over again, you can record those set of processes and use it as an action, so that whenever you play the action, Photoshop will automatically go through those processes for you. Let me now demonstrate what I just explained. Let's say I always duplicate my background layer, then I'll add a Gaussian blur to it. Let me make the radius 5. Then I create a group and name the group demo. Then inside the group, I usually add two adjustment layers, brightness and levels. Now you see how long that took me to actually do. Let me now play the action. I'll click on the action and click this play button here. And you see, in less than 1 or 2 seconds, the action has been done. Something that took me about a minute or so before. So to create an action, if you don't already have the actions tab open, you go up here to Windows and scroll to where you see actions and then click on it to make sure it is ticked. Then it will open up. Now I'm in the buttons mode, so let me show you the way you would see it when you open it for the first time. This is what you see when you open it for the first time. And me, I already have other actions installed, so that's why you're seeing it like this. So to create an action, I'll just create a group, name it demo. Then inside this folder, I'll create an action. So let's call this action repetitions. Then you can choose the function key, the shortcut key, and the color. So I'll just make the color red. I'll click on record. Now I'll do the same thing I did before. So I'll duplicate the background, go to my filter, blur, Gaussian blur, set it to 5, click on OK. Now create a new group, rename the group to demo, and then add two layers inside, brightness and levels. If we go back to actions now, you notice that all those things that I did have been recorded. So I'll now click on stop. Now that action has been saved, you can edit it later. But now this is the action in the folder demo repetition. So let me delete this and show you how fast the action will actually do it. Let me now play the action. I'll click on the action and click this play button here. And you see, in less than 1 or 2 seconds, the action has been done. Something that took me about a minute or so before. So you can actually use this to record processes that you go through that take you a lot of time, and it will actually reduce the time taking to do those actions to just a few seconds. Let me show you another action that I have. So I'll delete this. If I go to my button mode, when it is in button mode, it's just one click to play the action. Let's say I want to use my skin toning action, I'll just click on it. And my skin toning layer has been created. You can see everything here was just done in less than a minute. But if I was to do this manually, it would have taken me a whole lot of time. So that's it for actions. Let's move to the next one. So the next feature I'm going to show you guys in Photoshop that will save it is the keyboard shortcut feature. There are some tools in Photoshop that you actually have to go like deep inside to go and dig out, and they don't even have like a shortcut. So let's say I want to use color range selection tool in this picture. I'll now go to image, I'll go to select color range and select the color range that I want. Let's say I want the highlight and click on OK. Now that took me some time to go up here to image and to select and then click on color range. Same with, let's say I want to do a Gaussian blur I'll now go to filter, blur, and then choose Gaussian blur. That takes time. So you can create a keyboard shortcut that when you click, it will automatically just bring up the action. So let's say you want to create a keyboard shortcut for the color range selection tool. I'll just go to edit. Under that, you see a keyboard shortcut. Now under keyboard shortcut, to find the tool that you are looking for that you want to assign the shortcut, the other one was under select. So scroll to select and then we'll open it. Under it, you see the color range. This is the color range. Let's say the keyboard I want to assign to it is Shift Command R. Now this action is already used for something else, but I never use the thing that the keyboard shortcut is assigned to. So instead, I'll use it for this one. Click on accept here. I've assigned that shortcut and then click on OK. Now when I combine the key Shift Command R, that color range selection tool automatically comes up, so I don't have to go up here and select it again. So you see how easy it was. That is another thing that will save your time. Keyboard shortcuts, you can assign keyboard shortcut to every tool in Photoshop. That way you don't have to, you know, go and search for it. Just easily press two or three buttons together and it will come up. So that is the second feature. The third feature I'm going to show you guys that will save you time when you are working on Photoshop is the workspace customization feature. I actually made a whole video on this, so I'll leave a link to it in the description, but let me just quickly go through it. So when you get Photoshop the first time, you see the essential workspace. This is where the things that Photoshop feel is essential for you are, and most of the tools you don't need will be here. And the nice thing is that you can actually customize it to your own liking. They already have some workspace here that they have created for certain things like photography. As you can see, this one is targeted for photographers, but you can still customize it to your liking. So to customize a workspace, let's go back to the essential workspace. You just get rid of the things that you don't use and then add the things that you use and arrange it in a way that your hand can flow through the workspace effortlessly. That way you can work faster without having to go and search for tools. So let's say I don't use the color tab here, I'll just close it. I don't use swatches, I'll close it. I don't use gradients, I'll close it. Let's say I use properties, I'll go to windows here and add the properties window. Now it will come up like this. If I want it to be up here, I can take it up here. That way when I want to check, let's say I'm duplicating, where is the layer? You see, I can't, okay, the layers is down here. Let's say I'm duplicating this layer here. I can easily access the properties up here. So through that, I was able to set up my own workspace, which is this one, brand new one here. And this is how I like my workspace. I like my layers on top and then my properties down here. So if I create a new layer here, I can easily access the properties down here. This is how I set up my own workspace. You can customize it on. I'll leave a link to the video that will explain it better. Even the toolbar, the tools down here, there are so many tools here that you don't use, and there are those ones that you use that are hidden. You can actually bring them out and line them up in a way that it will be easily accessible to you. So to customize your toolbar, you just go to edit, toolbar, and under the toolbar you can move the tools that you don't want to the extra tools and it will be hidden. So let's say I don't want the move tool, I'll move it down to the extra tools, and as you can see, it has gone out of my toolbar. So let's say I want it back, I'll move it from the extra tools to the toolbar and it will show up here. So it's that easy. With those three features, you can actually save a lot of time when you are working on huge projects or when you are working with anything in Photoshop. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope you learned a thing or two. If you did, click on the like button. If you have a question, go down to the comment section, drop a comment down there. And if you are new to this channel, click on the subscribe button, ring the bell icon next to it so that you don't miss other awesome videos in future. See you guys in the next one.